My name is Ben Grout, and I'm the Austin Community Advocate for Chainlink.
Johnny Oxtonall, the founder of Linkpool.
Marco Mirabella, I'm the CEO of Ensuro.
I'm Melody, I'm the head of developer marketing here at Chainlink Labs.
I'm Michael Anderson, co-founder of Framework Ventures.
Toby Hill from Matrix Link.
Solange Gators, development advocate.
Toby Hill, advocate for Chainlink Labs.
Dahlia Malkhi, chief research officer at Chainlink Labs.
Back in the early days, it was quite fun because the entire Chainlink ecosystem was very greenfield.
Our goal was to find a consensus, like something that others are using, something that is reliable.
At the time, was looking for things that would increase scalability and the capabilities of smart contracts, and obviously this hit both of those.
Chainlink introduced technology for allowing smart contracts to access off-chain information and interact with the real world in a decentralized manner.
Chainlink community is just amazing. People is really friendly, really supportive.
Everyone's really willing to share and teach because it's constantly developing.
Having that camaraderie and shared belief that something was going to work.
Definitely the OG pillars of the community, the activeness on Twitter and social media in general.
It's great to see the Chainlink community evolve from this small gathering of people to now have like this active community hosting meetups all over the globe, active advocates, community managers.
It was people who were genuinely passionate about the technology and its potential. And that then is infectious and you get excited yourself.
If you're not having fun in these communities, it's not worth it. And but if you're also learning, you get a lot out of it.
The Chainlink community will grow more internationally as more people with different languages and different ideologies join the community. This will be the biggest community on the crypto space.
Chainlink itself as a network has, you know, really become mature over the years, especially from a technology point of view.
It's the one place where you can really point to a team of people over the last 5 years working on a singular mission to solve the Oracle problem.
Like Chainlink's great position in the sense that it's the market leader, but it's also battle tested. You know, it's very hardened.
You can see why this technology is so necessary for the whole ecosystem to thrive and grow. What really caught my attention was the possibility of having the real world and the blockchain world, like the data sources, to communicate with each other.
We're switching over from our existing Oracle to 100% Chainlink Oracles. One of the reasons for that is efficiency.
It's been a great kind of proving ground for us, just in terms of the connections and the capabilities that, you know, a Chainlink ecosystem can bring to just about anything in DeFi, gaming, you know, Web3 writ large.
It's right on that cusp of fundamentally changing, I think, how you and I go about our daily lives.
The places where you're going to be able to see, you know, innovation, new models coming about, you know, it's going to be with Chainlink.
We are enabling the developers with the right tools to create a better and more resilient future.
3 years is kind of a very long time in blockchain, but I believe it's just at the start. This technology is here to revolutionize a lot of the aspects in our everyday life. I believe that it's just the beginning of a bright future of Oracle, Chainlink, and in the entire blockchain industry.
Thanks everyone in the Chainlink community. We wouldn't be here without you.
Okay, let's go.
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 Let's go.